Dear students, I am Dr. K. Kannan, Professor of Mechanical Engineering, Anjaliyammal Mahalingam Engineering College, Kovilvanni. I am happy to meet you through the video lecture series on the subject heat mass transfer. This is lecture number 302 on the boiling heat transfer, and the topics for the today's discussion is problem on the boiling heat transfer. So in the earlier lecture, we discussed the boiling heat transfer, and we found some correlations for the boiling heat transfer calculations. And in this lecture, the learning outcome, the student will be able to solve problems on the boiling heat transfer. So we take up the first problem. This is from the university exam question paper. Water to be boiled at atmospheric pressure in a mechanically polished stainless steel pan placed on top of a heating unit. The inner surface of the bottom of the pan is maintained at the temperature 108 degrees Celsius. If the diameter of the bottom of the pan is 30 centimeter, determine the rate of heat transfer to the water and the rate of evaporation of the water. So after reading the problem, what are the parameter that you have to note it down? So this is a mechanically polished stainless steel pan. This is one parameter for our calculation. The surface temperature, wall temperature of the pan, and the diameter of the pan, and it is at atmospheric pressure. So the pressure, temperature of the saturation temperature is not given, but the atmospheric pressure is. Now the given data, pressure is 1 atmosphere, diameter equal to 0.3 meter, and the wall temperature is 108 degree Celsius. From the steam table, the saturation temperature at the 1 atmospheric pressure is 100 degree Celsius. Now you calculate the film temperature. So TF equal to TW plus TS divided by 2. So 108 plus 100 divided by 2 equal to 104 degree Celsius. Now at 104 degree Celsius, you take all the properties from the heat and mass transfer data book. Density of the water, liquid is water here. Density of the water is 957.8 kilograms per meter cube. Dynamic viscosity of the water, 2.7 to 10 power minus 4 Newton second per meter square. Specific heat of the liquid, 4222.8 joules per kilogram Kelvin. Prandtl number of water, 1.68. Density of the vapor, water vapor, 0.682 kilograms per meter cube. HFG equal to 2246.3 in 10 power 3 joules per kilogram. N equal to 1 for the water. CSF is a constant, 0.0132 for water in a polished stainless steel pan. And delta T equal to 108 minus 100 equal to 8 degrees Celsius. And the sigma surface tension equal to 0.0588 newtons per meter. All these data are available in the heat and mass transfer data book. You have to refer the data book for this temperature, for water table and water vapor, steam table, and the other for HFG and sigma value, you have to refer to the boiling table. And normally the value may not be available directly. The data may be available for 100 degrees Celsius or 120 or 140 degrees Celsius. You have to do the interpolation and take all the data. So it will take time. You take your time. Calculate, interpolate direct carefully and take the data, because the data are important for accurate result. Carefully take the data. Then the heat flux, you take the correlation from the heat and mass transfer data book. Q by A heat flux, Q by A equal to mu L HFG, G into rho L minus rho V divided by sigma to the power 0.5 into CL into delta T divided by CSF, HFG, Prandtl number to the power n to the power 3. Substitute all the values, mu L equal to 2.7 to 10 power minus 4, HFG equal to 2246.3 in 10 power 3, and G equal to 9.81, rho L equal to 957.8, rho V equal to 0.682, sigma equal to 0.0588 to the power 0.5, and CL, specific heat of the liquid, equal to 4222.8. Delta T equal to 8 and divided by CSF equal to 0.0132, HFG equal to 2246.3 into 10 power 3 and the Prandtl number equal to 1.68 to the power 1, that is to the power 1 equal to 1.68 to the power 3, and calculating the heat flux equal to 76.15 kilowatts per meter square. You have to use the calculator carefully and solve the equation. And the rate of heat transfer, Q equal to heat flux into area of the pan. So pi by 4 d square is the area of the pan into heat flux. So pi by 4 into 0.3 square into 76.15 into 1000 equal to 5.38 kilowatt. That is the amount of heat transfer. Then the rate of evaporation of the water, mass equal to m equal to q by hfg, substituting for q 5.38 into 1000 and hfg equal to 2246.3 into 1000. The amount of water evaporated is 2.395 in 10 power minus 3 kilograms per second or 8.62 kilograms per hour. So the answers are, rate of heat transfer to the water is 5.38 kilowatts and the rate of evaporation of the water is 8.62 kilograms per hour. So just to recall the steps for the problem, first you read the problem, understand, write down the given data, calculate the film temperature, take the properties, take the appropriate equation, substitute the values, carefully calculate and write down the result. This is the steps to solve the problem. Now we take the second problem. Water at atmospheric pressure is to be boiled in a polished copper pan. The diameter of the pan is 350 millimeter and it is kept at 115 degrees Celsius. Calculate the following. Power of the burner, rate of evaporation kilograms per hour and critical heat flux. So write down the problem, read down the problem and write down the note down the data. So the polished copper pan, diameter of the pan is 350 millimeter, wall temperature is 115 degree Celsius. So it is at again atmospheric pressure. So P equal to 1 atmosphere, diameter is 0.35 meter, wall temperature is 115 degree Celsius. So from this steam table, the saturation temperature at 1 atmosphere is 100 degrees Celsius. Then we calculate the film temperature. So 115 plus 100 divided by 2, which is 107.5 degrees Celsius. You take all the properties from Heaton mass transfer data book at 107.5 degrees Celsius. So rho L here, rho L equal to 954.6 kilograms per meter cube. Viscosity is 2.62 10 power minus 4 Newton second per meter square. Specific heat is 4229.6 joules per kilogram Kelvin and Prandtl number is 1.6224. Density of the steam is 0.776 kilograms per meter cube. HFG equal to 2235.4 10 power 3 joules per kilogram. N equal to 1 for the water and the CSF equal to 0.0128 for water in a polished copper pan and delta T equal to 15 degrees Celsius and sigma equal to 0.0588 Newton per meter. And substitute all the values, right? Take the equation from the Heaton mass transfer data book, substitute the values. So mu L equal to 2.62 in 10 power minus 4, HFG equal to 2235.4 in 10 power 3, and G equal to 9.81, density of vapor rho L equal to 945.6, rho V equal to -0.776 divided by sigma equal to 0.0588 to the power 0.5 and the CL equal to 4229.6 and delta T equal to 15 divided by CSF equal to 0.0128, HFG equal to 2235.4 in 10 power 3 and Prandtl number equal to 1.6224 to the power 3. Carefully using the calculator and solving the numerical values, you will get the Q heat flux equal to 582.4 in 10 power 3 watts per meter square. Now the power of the burner, that is what the heat transfer to the water. Power of the burner is equal to heat transfer to the water. So Q equal to pi by 4 d square into Q, that is equal to pi by 4 into 0.35 square into heat flux equal to 582.4 in 10 power 3. That is equal to 56.06 kilowatts. Then the rate of evaporation, m equal to q by hfg. So q equal to 56.06 in 10 power 3, that is 1000, divided by HFG equal to 2235.4 into 1000, that is equal to 0.025 kilograms per second or 90 kilograms per hour. A critical heat flux, once again refer to the heat and mass transfer data book. Take the equation Q by A maximum equal to 0.18 HFG rho V multiplied by sigma G into rho L minus rho V divided by rho V square to the power 0.25, substituting 0.18 HFG equal to 2235.4 into 10 power 3 and rho V equal to 0.776 multiplied by sigma equal to 0.0588, G equal to 9.81, rho L equal to 954.6 minus 0.776 divided by 0.776 square to the power 0.25. Using the calculator, calculate the numerically solve the equation and you find maximum heat flux equal to 1.72 in 10 power 6 watts per meter square. Then the results are power of the burner, that is heat transfer to the water, is 56.06 kilowatts. Rate of evaporation kilogram per hour is 90. Critical heat flux is 1.72 10 power 6 watts per meter square. Then the third example, water is boiled at 120 degree Celsius in a mechanically polished stainless steel pressure cooker placed on top of the heating unit. If the inner surface or the bottom of the cooker is maintained at a temperature of 128 degree Celsius, determine boiling heat transfer coefficient. And the data given are TS, or saturation temperature, is 120 degree Celsius and the wall temperature of the cooker is 128 degree Celsius. It is mechanically polished stainless steel cooker. And the film temperature, this is TW plus TS divided by 2, which is 124 degree Celsius. Now, if you take the data from the data book at 124 degree Celsius, so density of the liquid 941.6 kilograms per meter cube, viscosity of the liquid 2.26 to 10 power minus 4 newton second per meter square, specific heat of the liquid 4251.65 joules per kilogram Kelvin, Prandtl number 1.405, density of the vapor 0.56584 kilograms per meter cube, HFG equal to 2187.924 in 10 power 3 joules per kilogram, N equal to 1 for the water, CSF equal to 0.0132 for water in a polished stainless steel cooker, delta T equal to 8 degree Celsius and sigma equal to 0.054 Newton per meter. Now you take the heat flux equation from the data book, write down the equation and substitute the numerical values. So mu L equal to 2.26 to 10 power minus 4 into HFG equal to 2187.924 in 10 power 3, G equal to 9.81, rho L equal to 941.6 minus rho V equal to 0.56584 divided by sigma equal to 0.54 to the power 0.5 and CPL equal to 4251.65, delta T equal to 8, CSF equal to 0.0132 and HFG equal to 2187.924, Prandtl number equal to 1.405 to the power 3. Using the calculator, solve the equation numerically and you will get heat flux equal to 1.2 into 10 power 5 watts per meter square. And boiling heat transfer coefficient. So the Q equal to H equal to Q by delta T. So heat transfer equal to H into delta T. So H equal to Q by delta T, which is 1.2 into 10 power 5 divided by 8 equal to 15,000 watts per meter square Kelvin. The answer for the problem, the boiling heat transfer coefficient is 15,000 watts per meter square Kelvin. So here the equations are straight away available in the data book. The only carefully what you have to do is taking the data at the film temperature from the heat and mass transfer data book. If you do it well, and you can easily solve the problem. So these are all the reference book I referred for the problem, for problem solving for the subject. And I have a book published on the subject, heat and mass transfer by another publications. You can refer to the book for additional problems on the same topic. And if you have any queries, you can write to me to my mail ID. I will sincerely answer to your queries. So thank you. We'll meet again.